So dear students, today we are going to do a new poem from your syllabus, that is the Snake Crying. This poem is written by a poet W.W.E. Rose. See, in this poem we will come to know that basically, suppose I give you one situation. Suppose any of the snake comes in front of you, what would be your reaction? You will be telling me your reaction only in one word. Suppose snake comes here, you just frightened, only raise your hands.
Horrified,
fainted, scared, frightened, screaming, okay.
Astonished.
So these all are the words. Okay, listen. Okay. So from all these words, I have come to know that you will be scared, you will be frightened, some would be feeling fainted, okay. You will not have courage to face that snake, isn't it? And some will definitely try to hit it so that it should be killed. Not, tell me. So that it should not harm anybody. So all kind of response I'm getting from you. So this is the response from every human being, that if snake comes in front of them, how would they feel? They would be feeling frightened, scared. Okay, they would be trying to kill that snake. They would be feeling horrified. Some would be feeling fainted. So such kind of feelings you would be developing if any in any of the situations snake comes in front of you. And it happens with every human being, not of your class student. With every human being, it is natural. So why does it happen? Why? See, Kavarnur has given this point that it has become our perspective. From it has become our mindset. Yes, from our birth also. When we were a child, very small child. So this assumption is set fixed in our mind that these are poisonous, these are harmful, they are going to harm us. So that's why whenever snake comes in front of us, we become scared. Because it is a mindset, it is poisonous, it is harmful. This is a mindset we all people have developed. First of all, now be attentive, listen to me, only then I will be enjoying teaching and you people will be enjoying learning. I want your participation. I don't want to teach walls. I want to teach human beings. So involve yourself in my discussion. So this is the assumption that we people have, you can say, gathered in our mind. It is our perception that these are poisonous, these are harmful. Okay. So it is basically very much terrifying, very much horrified. Okay. Everybody feels scared at the sight of Raghav. Please, bachche, sit there. Wait. This boy, Sahil, be in center. Let me see, your face should be very much visible. Now from where the voice is coming. Now maintain silence and listen to me. So here in this poem, the poet has tried to show the snake not like a, you can say, creature from where we should be afraid. The snake is to be a victim itself, okay? So here in this poem, the snake is depicted like that. It is not going to harm anyone. this snake, which is going to be depicted in this poem, it is not going to be harm anyone, okay? Its intention is only to attack, because whenever there is a reason to self-defense, whenever he wants to protect himself, only then he will be attacking. Otherwise, he is not going to attack on any of the human body, human being, okay? It was even harmless to create to children also. It is not going to harm anyone, okay? And the poet has fallen into love with the charm, with the grace, with the beauty of a snake. How the snake is depicted here in this poem? It is very, yes, it is very charming. It has a very gracious presence. It is very beautiful. Okay, you can say it is elegant. It has a elegance, okay? Its beauty, its charm, its grace, it is depicted so beautifully in this poem. Elegant means the, you can say beauty, okay? So how it is going to be depicted in this poem? So we will be studying it in detail. So let's go through the poem. The snake trying to escape the pursuing stick with sudden curving of thin long body. How beautiful and graceful are his shapes. He glides through the water away from the stalk. Oh, let him go over the water into the reeds to hide without hurt. Small and green, he is harmless even to children. Along the sand he lay until observed and chased away, and how he vanishes in the ripples among the green slim reeds. So you go through this poem and find out the rhyming words and rhyming scheme. Tell me. Do you think there is any rhyme scheme?
No.
Are you able to find out rhyming verbs?
No.
So you are not able to find out rhyming words. You are not able to find out rhyming scheme. So this poem is written in? Free verbs. So whenever you are not able to find out any rhyming words and rhyming scheme, we'll be saying that this poem is written in free verbs. Arvind, you shift to say last tense. So this poem is written in free verse. Okay. So here I'm going to explain only first four lines of the poem in detail. So to understand the poem of, to understand first four lines, you have to write down the meaning of escape. Escape means, what is the meaning of escape? To avoid. So, bachche, write down the meaning of these difficult words. Escape means to avoid. Pursuing. Pursuing means approaching. Bachche, write down the meanings of difficult words. Pursuing. Pursuing means approaching, approaching towards something. But this pursuing word, according to this poem, it is approaching towards something. Otherwise, can you use pursue word in some sense? Yes, I'm pursuing this degree from this institute. Otherwise, pursue word is used in this sense. I'm pursuing this degree from this institute. It means I'm getting education. I'm gaining that education. But here pursuing, same thing, approaching towards something. Pursue means to proceed towards something.
He's pursuing
towards
money.
No. Curving. Write down the meaning of curving. Write down the meaning of curving. Curving means, you can say, a movement. coming means a movement. Okay, after that write down the meaning of graceful. Graceful means elegant and elegant, charming. Okay, and here what is the meaning of shapes? Moves. Now after writing the meanings of these difficult words, I'm going to explain only first four lines, so listen carefully. Moves. So bachche, have you written these meanings? Escape means to avoid. Pursuing means approaching towards something. Curving, a movement. Graceful, elegant and charming. And shapes is moves. Okay, now let's understand the meaning of this. In this stanza, the poet is describing how a snake is trying to avoid the approaching stick with an elegant and non-linear moves of its body. The poet is writing here, the snake is trying to avoid itself from that stick. Which stick? Which is approaching towards snake. So he is trying, because who is using that stick?
Human being.
Why are they using?
To
hit it or to kill it, to harm it, but he is trying to avoid from that stick. And how it is avoiding? With sudden curving of thin long body. Because the way it is moving shapes, it is moving, you can say move, it is taking movements. Okay, it is moving in different directions. So from those gestures, we can say, okay, that its moves are very much elegant. Its moves are very much graceful, very much beautiful. So by using that moves, it is trying to avoid, it is trying to escape from the hit of that stick. Clear? Am I clear? Two lines are clear. Okay. After that, the poet is saying how beautiful and graceful are his shapes. Shapes mean moves. The way it moves, its moves are very much, you can say, attractive, very much beautiful. You can remember, you might have seen snakes in movies. How does it move like that in zigzag motion? Okay. So its body is elegant, graceful, charm. There is a charm in that. Okay. So first four lines are clear. He glides through the water away from the stalk. Oh, let him go over the water into the reeds to hide without hurt. So here the poet is saying glides. Glides means to go across something. Write down the meanings of glides. Glides mean to go across something. To go across something. Stroke. What is the meaning of stroke? The efforts on something. The efforts on something. Stroke, to efforts on something. Reeds. Can anybody tell me what is the meaning of reeds? Yes. Reeds are basically plants, water plants. Okay. Harmless means without any harm. So here in these next four lines, the poet is trying to say that the snake has already made its way. It is moving, okay? And it is moving where? In water, okay? So in this stanza, the poet has described that the afraid snake is making its own way. The snake is already scared. It is already scared of human being. And it is trying to make its way into the water. Why so? Why it has made its way into the water? So that it can hide and it can avoid the stroke of hit of human. It can avoid the possible harm. It can avoid the hit and go unhurt into the reeds.
We are afraid of it, and he is also afraid of us.
Because human beings can hit them at any time. They can kill them. So snake is afraid because he wants to avoid hit of that stick. He wants to avoid that, you can say, because that's why it is hiding itself into water. It wants to go into that reeds, water plants. It wants. You will come to know later on when you will go through the whole poem. So the poet requests us. So through these four lines, the poet wants to say the plight, the condition of a snake, that how it is trying to escape into water. Why so? Because at any time, human being can hit them with stick. It can harm them. It can kill them. So the poet is telling that the snake is trying to make every possible effort in order to save its life. So sometime it is going here and there. It has described its movement, that how it is moving. And through that, it is also appreciated the beauty, the elegance of its body. The how its body is so elegant. Okay? How gracious it is, its body. After that, it is trying, it is making its every possible effort to hide itself into the water. Reeds, reed plants, so that it can avoid any of the hit, any of the harmful action of human being. Am I clear? Okay. But here the poet is also requesting us not to cause any harm. Not to cause any harm to that beautiful snake, because this snake is harmless. It is not causing any harm to human body. Even to children, small and green, he is harmless even to children. So here the poet is saying this snake is so small, it is green, it is not causing any harm, even it is not causing any harm to any child. Okay. Along the sand he lay until observed and chased away, and how he vanishes in the ripples among the green slim reeds. So, bachche, write down difficult meanings of third stanza. Only then you will be able to understand the proper meaning of this stanza. Last switch, bachche, switch on that white one. So, bachche, write down observed. Observed means, observed means seen and watched, or you can say seen and observed, chased. What is the meaning of chased?
Follow.
Yes,
follow.
Very good. Chased means
to follow.
To follow. To follow. After that, vanishes. Yes. So, bachche, write down the meaning of vanishes. Vanishes means to disappear. Write down the meaning of vanishes, disappear. Ripples. Ripples means the movement of water current. Ripples means the movement of water current. Let me finish with this. After that, I'll take a round and see you about. I will be telling you your performance in personal, that what you people are doing in class. And slim, you can say
thin.
So, bachche, these meanings I have written here. Now try to understand the meaning of these poems. So the poet in this stanza says that green snake, its snake's color is green. It is green in color. Its size is very small. Okay. And it was lying along the sand. It was lying along the sand. And until it was observed by someone. It means its color is green. It is mixed with other plants. So until it is not observed by someone, so it is not going to be noticed. Okay. But so it was not causing any harm. It was not chasing somebody. It was sitting still there. But as soon as it was seen, it was spotted, it was observed. So after that, what happened? The snake started moving fast because it was spotted, it was seen, it was observed by one of the human being. So as soon as it was seen, it started moving so fast and it hid itself also. Okay. So in this way, it saved itself from the pursuer. And the color of the reeds where it is hiding, the color of reeds is also green. Now, when I taught you these three stanza, do you think any image comes in your mind?
Yes, ma'am.
What kind of image was coming?
Image of the desert and snake is moving in sand.
Okay. You just stand up and tell me what kind of image was going, because for last 15 minutes, we are discussing about this point. Okay, we have been discussing about this point. So what kind of image came in your mind? Okay. Okay. It means the image of snake, image of greenery, image of sand. Okay. Okay, you are saying image of a waterfall. So from this reading, from this explanation, now you will be able to understand when you will be going, you are going through this poem. There is one of the poetic device used, and this poetic device is
imagery.
This poetic device is imagery. Why it is imagery? Because imagery, yes, imagery, basically it is a figurative language and it represents the object. Okay. And it is representing in the physical. We are going to observe it by using our physical senses. How many senses do we have? Which one? So when you are using imagery in this poem, which imagery you have used? So here imagery is used, and now find out the examples of imagery, because when you go through this poem, this image comes across your mind. So what is that? Let's find out. Start from the very beginning. To escape the pursuing stick, any image comes in your mind?
Yes,
ma'am. So very second line, to escape the pursuing stick with sudden curving of thin long body, any image comes in your mind?
Yes, ma'am.
Which kind of? It's about its graceful movement. So you can well imagine with the eyes of your mind. You can visualize. You are not able to see with your eyes, but you can visualize by using your mind. So here, which poetic device is used? It is used imagery. And if I in your paper it is asked that give example of this poetic device, imagery, and what example? To escape the pursuing stick with sudden curving of thin long body. And in another example, yes, he glides through the water away from the stroke. So here very clear image comes in your mind that poet is trying to escape itself and it is hiding through water. Okay, so this poem is clear to you? Okay. What is the snake trying to escape from? Who is chasing it using a stick? Why? Okay, Sahil, you come here and tell me this answer. What is the snake trying to escape from? Come here. Now I can call any of the child here to give me answer, so that your performance will be very much clear in front of the class and it will be recorded also. And you will also come to know that where do people stand. Sahil, come out. After that, Sahil, I'm going to ask Akhilesh. And after Akhilesh, Kavardhu. Come in front of camera. Here it is camera. First answer, pick up this mic. Speak.
The snake was trying to escape from the human being which was holding a stick. He was human being was holding the stick because he was also scared of the snake.
Next one, come.
The snake is trying to escape from a human being who's using his powers to hit a harmful snake. Harmless.
Only one line answer.
All likhan.
So stand there in front of camera. I've explained the whole poem and you haven't written anything.
Let me look.
So, bachche, now we are running out of time. So, you go through all these question answers. Okay. Write down some of the points. And all this discussion of question answer will be done tomorrow. Kavandur, come here.